Hey, good morning. It's Dr. James. I am so deeply grateful to see you today. Thanks for showing up. Thank you for your time and thank you for your energy. And this morning, like I always do, the first thing I did upon waking is I went directly into prayer. And this morning's prayer was such a simple prayer that literally made me feel so humble and then made me feel so wildly awake. The prayer was this: help me to share something with you today that breaks open your heart, that widens your perspective in such a way that if you this morning woke up and you were wondering whether or not you had a sense of purpose, a sense of meaning, a sense of something that you knew was going to make this day a tremendous demonstration, expression of you living your life with purpose in such a way that at the end of this day, you go to sleep and you're like, oh my gosh, that was an amazing day. Because you learned one wonderful thing about you. And this wonderful thing that you're going to learn about you today is what really makes you come alive. And I promise you, this is based on some fabulous and very, very sad science. This sad science comes from a man named Viktor Frankl out of his book, Man's Search for Meaning. You've probably heard of it. Viktor Frankl was a psychiatrist. And this research began while he was in the Nazi death camps in World War II. He and his family were put into the Nazi death camps, and most all of the people he knew in his family, his friends, relatives, they all died. Viktor Frankl survived. He, along with a very small handful of others, survived this particular Nazi death camp experience. And he took notes. He took mental notes. He took heart notes. And he was trying to figure out who survived and why did they survive. What was it that gave them meaning? And he went on to share with something over the last several decades of his life since he survived the Nazi death camps, went on to write and become one of the most prolific psychiatrists, clinicians, healers the world has ever known. And this book always sits on my desk side because I don't read it every day, but all I need to do is get up in the morning and I look over and I see that book and I go, ah, this is what it's all about. And what he basically goes on to share in this book is something called logotherapy. And this is what I want you to learn about you today. This is about you understanding what makes you come alive. It's about understanding what your deep purpose is in life. And if you lately, like me, have been seeing your life go, man, I wake up and I just wonder what's going to happen today. I wake up and I go, man, do I have what it takes to navigate today? Am I going to get pummeled by bad news? Is there something that's going to come into my consciousness, something that's going to seep into my heart, that's going to knock me down, and I'm going to wonder if I have the courage and the conviction to get back up again? Well, there's something I want to share with you right now from this book that I believe you will have a sense of connection to that it'll change your life today. And that is this whole idea of logotherapy, which he basically says people are either driven by pleasure or meaning. And in logotherapy, he saw firsthand what gave people the deepest sense of survival instincts and gave them a sense of such a powerful courage to get up and make something amazing happen, to survive against all odds, to outshine the darkest of the dark, to outlove the deepest sense of hate. And guess what he found out? When we pursue pleasure, and if pleasure is the thing that we are going after, if pleasure is what gives us a sense of meaning and fulfillment, there's a pretty good chance we will not have a great life of meaning. Man's search for meaning has nothing to do with going after and seeking only pleasure. What it is, it's meaning. Man's search for meaning is what it's all about. So today, I encourage you to ask yourself a simple question. What gives you meaning? What makes you come alive? What makes you feel possible? What makes you wake up? What makes you, when you look in the mirror, you say to yourself, oh my gosh, this is my life. This is what I'm here to do. And I don't know if I have the business of in believing I can do this, but trust me on this. If you know what gives you meaning, if you know what wakes you up, if you know what makes you feel possible, then this is what you are here to do. And your life's work is to pursue your meaning with absolute abandon. This is what it's all about. Your search for meaning is what gives you meaning. And this pursuit will change your life. This pursuit will change the world around you. This opportunity to identify your life's work through knowing your meaning is what you are here to do. So today, let's pursue our meaning. Let's express it. Let's exploit it. Let's circulate it like our lives depend on it, because they do. Let's rise, let's shine, and let's take Victor's work to heart. Let's create a life that we love. I love you. Much love, many blessings. Have an awesome day. Bye for now.